Hello everybody, are you ready for one more story? So, vocês... Olá pessoal, vocês estão prontos para mais uma historinha? Eu sou Jéssica, eu sou a professora de inglês em formação. Pessoal, eu estou aqui com essa historinha about the three bears. Então é a historinha sobre os três ursos, né? Have you heard about Goldilocks and the three bears? Né? Aquela caixinhos dourados. Já ouviram falar sobre caixinhos dourados e os três ursos? So that's what this book is talking about. É sobre isso que o livro está falando. E so today everybody we are going to read this story. I hope you enjoy it with me. And if you like this video, if you like my content, can you help me hitting a like in my video so you could spread to other people for them to know that we are having this work here? And this is so important, okay? So let's get started. Let's read. This is the story of the three bears. Once upon a time, there were three bears. They lived in a house in the woods. These are the three bears, 1, 2, 3. Papa Bear, Mama Bear, and Baby Bear. They lived in a house in the woods. One of the bears was Papa Bear. One was Mama Bear. And one was Baby Bear. Okay? Each of them had their own porridge bowl. There was three bowls of porridge on the table. Papa Bear had a great big bowl. Mama Bear, this is the great big bowl. This is the biggest on the table. Mama Bear had a middle-sized bowl. This is the middle-sized bowl. Mom and Baby Bear had a wee little bowl. This is the Baby Bear wee little bowl. Come, my baby, can you join me into the story? Então, pessoal, existia, né, na floresta uma casa onde moravam os três ursinhos, né? Existia o papai urso, a mamãe urso e o bebê urso, que eles moravam na floresta. Cada um deles tinha o seu prato, a sua tigela para comer, o seu mingau, né? There were three bowls of porridge. So, and they each had a chair to sit on. All of them had their chair, okay? A chair to sit on. And Papa Bear had a great big chair. This is the biggest chair in the house. This is from Papa Bear. Mama Bear had a middle-sized chair. This is the middle-sized chair from Mama Bear. And Baby Bear had a wee little chair, okay? Baby Bear had the wee little chair. It's the smallest one, okay? This. Então, existia a cadeira maior, né? A cadeira grande, a cadeira média e a cadeira pequenininha. Alright? Each bear had a bed to sleep in, too. So each of them also had their bed just to sleep. Papa Bear had a great big bed. Papa Bear had a great big bed. Look at the size. It's so large. And Mama Bear had a middle-sized bed. This is Mama Bear's bed, the middle-sized bed. And Baby Bear, he had A wee little bed. Look at this size, so cute. Olha o tamanhozinho dessa cama, né? É a menor de todas. It's the smallest one. Let's continue. One morning, the three bears cooked some porridge for breakfast. While it was cooling, they went out into the woods in search of sweet honey. Então, uma certa manhã, eles saíram, né? Eles, primeiramente, eles cozinharam um mingau e enquanto esfriava, eles foram dar um passeio na floresta esperando o mingau esfriar. While it was cooling, while the porridge was cooling, they went out into the woods in search of honey. Então eles saíram à procura de mel. Wow, delicious. So they went out, okay, in the woods. Eles saíram da floresta. After they left, a little girl named Goldilocks passed by their house. She knocked on the door. This is the girl. She's passing by the house, and she knocked the door. She noticed that, and no one answered the door. Okay, no one answered the door. So she went right in. So there was this girl that she was passing by the house in the woods, and she noticed that no one was at home, and she knocked the door, and she decided, I'm going to enter this house. She was entering to see what she was going to find. Goldilocks was rather hungry, so she decided to eat some of the porridge. This is the girl. She entered inside the house, which is not polite to enter in someone's house without permission, né? Então, essa menininha, ela entrou na casa dos ursos, né? Ela percebeu que não tinha ninguém em casa e ela pensou, vou entrar e dar uma olhadinha. E ela estava com muita fome. She was too hungry. She was rather hungry. So she decided to eat some of the porridge. Ela decidiu comer, né, de uma das tigelas do mingau. It smelled so good. It smelled so good. First, she tasted the porridge from Papa Bear's great big bowl. Then, she tasted the porridge from Mama Bear's middle-sized bowl. She tasted the middle-sized bowl, the porridge. But it was too hot for her. Okay? And then, in Papa Bear's great big bowl, but it was too hot. It was too hot. She could not eat it. Estava muito quente, né? Então ela não conseguiu comer da tigela do papai urso. And she tasted the porridge from Mama Bear's middle-sized bowl, but it was too hot too, as well. It was too hot as well. And then she tasted the porridge from Baby Bear's wee little bowl. She tasted the last one, okay? From the baby bear. From the baby bear's wee little bowl. It was just right. So she liked it. It was delicious and in the right temperature. Então, ela provou de todos os mingaus, né? Se eu posso dizer assim, das tigelinhas dos ursos. E provou e percebeu que o do ursinho, a tigelinha menor, estava perfeito. Estava delicioso. Estava na temperatura correta, alright? So she ate it all up. Então ela comeu tudo. Goldilocks felt tired. After eating, she felt tired. So she sat down in Papa Bear's great big chair. She sat down in Papa Bear's great big chair. But it was too hard for her. She did not like to sit in that chair because it was too hard. Hard like wall. Walls are hard. It is not comfortable. Então ela sentou na cadeira do papai urso, viu que era muito dura, né? Não era confortável. And she's going to try another one. Then she sat down in Mama Bear's middle-sized chair. She sat down in Mama Bear's middle-sized chair. But it was too soft for her. So it was not, this chair was not hard. It was soft. Too soft. Okay? Soft like a couch. Okay? A couch is soft. And she did not like it. I don't know why. And then she sat down in Baby Bear's wee little chair. It was just right for her. She tried the wee little chair of the baby bear. But she didn't. She liked it, okay? She liked it. It was just right, but it broke. She broke the chair. Oh, and she fell down. Ela caiu, né? Ela tentou, ela gostou da cadeirinha, que era a menor de todas, mas it was fragile for her. Era frágil. Then Goldilocks went upstairs to the three bears' bedroom. First, she lay down on Papa Bear's great big bed. She went upstairs to the bedroom just to rest. She wanted to sleep maybe, okay? And then she tried the Papa Bear's great big bed, but it was too hard for her. Then she lay down on Mama Bear's middle-sized bed, but it was too soft for her. And then she lay down on Baby Bear's wee little bed. It was not too hard, it was not too soft, and it was just right for her. So she pulled up the cover, she pulled up the cover on her and went to sleep. She took a nap, okay? This is Goldilocks in the baby's bed, the wee little bed. She's going to sleep now. Soon after, the three bears came home, and she was not expecting them to come home to return. They noticed that something was wrong. "Somebody has been eating my porridge," said Papa Bear in his great big voice. He was so scared and worried about what happened. What could happen with his porridge? Someone has eaten it. Alguém tinha comido, ele percebeu que algo não estava certo, que alguém tinha entrado e mexido nas coisas deles, alright? "Somebody has been eating my porridge," said Mama Bear in her middle-sized voice. "And somebody has been eating my porridge and has eaten it all up," cried Baby Bear in his little voice. Okay? Hello, my baby.
Hello.
What are you doing, my baby? Are you eating, little baby? So, are you going to listen to the story? Can you sit here, please? So, let's listen to the story, my boy. And the cried baby bear in his wee little voice.
Voice.
The baby bear was crying because someone has eaten the whole porridge, his whole porridge, okay? There was nothing left. The bowl was empty. Look at his bowl, it was empty.
Empty.
Yes, the.
Tava empty.
Yes, now
Tava
he
empty.
was going to stay hungry now. Oh,
Hungry now.
that's why he's crying. Por isso que o.
Oh.
Oh no, the baby bear is going to stay hungry.
Oi. A menina.
Yes, it was the girl, Goldilocks.
Goldilocks.
The three bears knew somebody was in their house. So in this moment, they knew that someone had, someone ate their porridge. So they're going to discover, who did it. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said Papa Bear in his great big voice. Somebody has been sitting in my chair. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said Mama Bear in her middle-sized voice. So she was telling her husband, the Papa Bear, that someone has been sitting in her chair too. And somebody has been sitting in my chair and has broken it, cried Baby Bear in his wee little voice. And the Baby Bear was telling his mommy that someone has been sitting and that someone broke his chair. Então ele estava contando para a mamãe dele que alguém teria entrado sentado na cadeirinha e quebrou. E tinha quebrado sua cadeirinha, né? The three bears hurried upstairs to the bedroom. Somebody has been lying in my bed, said Papa Bear. Somebody has been lying in my bed, said Mama Bear. So they noticed that someone had laid in their bed, and it was just a mess. The bedroom was messy. O quarto, né? O quarto deles estava bagunçado porque alguém tinha entrado e teria, né, deitado na cama deles. In each bed. And somebody has been lying in my bed, and there she is, cried Baby Bear. This is the Baby Bear crying and telling his parents that someone had been lying in his bed and that she was still in the bed. Então ele estava contando para os seus pais, né, que alguém teria entrado, deitado na cama dele e que ela ainda estava lá. So there she is, he said, there she is. Lá está ela. He found her, he found Goldilocks that was waking up. Então ele encontrou a menininha e ela estava acordando. Let's see. Goldilocks woke up. She woke up. When she saw the three bears, she jumped out of bed, raced down the stairs, and ran out the front door, ok? Então, ela, quando percebeu que eles tinham descoberto que ela estava lá, ela acordou assustada. E ela saiu da cama, né? Pulou da cama. She jumped out of bed, raced down the stairs, correu pelas escadas, and ran out the front door. Então, ela saiu correndo pela porta também, né? She was running away. Então, literalmente, ela estava fugindo dos ursos. She was so scared that she could not wait anymore. Então, ela estava tão assustada que ela não podia mais esperar, né? So, Goldilocks ran as fast as she could through the woods. The three bears called for her to come back. But Goldilocks ran and ran. And the three bears never saw her again. So there she is. There she goes running in the woods, going home maybe. Probably she's going home then because she was so tired and she was scared. She had eaten and messed all the three bears' house. And that's what she could do. She could just run away. So everybody, what do you think about this story? What's the moral that this story brings to us? This story mainly says that it's not right to touch, or we have to respect other people's privacy and property. Então temos que respeitar, né, a privacidade das outras pessoas. We're not allowed to enter in someone's house if we're not invited to come in. Então não devemos, né, entrar na casa de outras pessoas sem ser convidados. And people should not touch in someone else's things unless they ask for you to do this. Não podemos mexer nas coisas de outras pessoas a menos que elas peçam para que a gente faça isso. Alright? So, what else can we learn about this story? We can know some words from the story, some vocabulary, which are bear. Bear means, algumas palavras que nós podemos aprender da historinha é bear, significa urso, né? Porridge, o mingau, né, que eles estavam comendo, que eles deixaram esfriando, e a garota foi lá e provou de cada um. The family, they are a family, a bear family, né, eles são uma família de ursos. They lived in the woods, então eles moravam na floresta, ok? Bowl, tigela, table, these are some things that we find, that we can find in a house. São algumas coisas que nós podemos encontrar em nossa casa, né? Que é a mesa, pratos, né? Bowls, the spoon, colher, the chairs. Chair significa cadeira. A chair. What else? O que mais? Bed, a cama. Bedroom, quarto. This is the part of the house that we usually go to sleep in. Então, o quarto é o lugar onde as pessoas vão, né, para dormir. To rest, descansar. The woods means the forest, a floresta. And in the story says that the bears went to find, they went out in search of honey. Honey, aqui na historinha diz que eles saíram em busca de mel, né? Honey significa mel. So I hope you have enjoyed this story, everybody. Eu espero que vocês tenham gostado, que possam compartilhar com seus amigos, que você que é mãe ou pai, eu super recomendo esse livro, certo? Porque ele tem um vocabulário super simples, muito fácil de explicar para as crianças. E a história, né, através das histórias, a criança vai internalizando a estrutura da língua inglesa, vai também aprender novos vocabulários e vai aprender a gostar da leitura desde a infância. So that's why I recommend this book. Eu recomendo esse livro, né, porque ele é super legal. É um clássico da literatura, né? É um conto de fadas. It's a fairy tale, so it's so good for you to have in your house, ok? For your children. Então, espero que vocês tenham gostado. Deixem o seu gostei e se inscrevam no nosso canal. E que vocês estejam sempre por aqui, nos acompanhando e nos ajudando aqui nessa trajetória do aprendizado da língua inglesa, certo? Espero que vocês possam aprender. Então, see you later. See you next video. Bye, bye.